Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In the last video, we learned about cascading style sheets, introduction, and levels of CSS, and level 1, CSS level 1, CSS level 2, and CSS level 3, and types of CSS. They are classified into three types. One is inline style sheets, and internal style sheets, and external style sheets. In this session, we need to learn about selector. Okay, so initially in this topic we are discussing about cascading style sheets, CSS selector, ID selector, class selector, and grouping selector. So we need to learn these parts in this video. So coming to the first one, CSS cascading style sheets, also called as CSS. CSS enables web authors and programmers to finely tune elements for publishing both online and across several different types of media, including print format. Okay, the features are search engine optimization, browser compatibility, appearance, maintenance, bandwidth saving, file size, and tableless layouts. Regarding search engine optimization, also called as SEO, it is more powerful thing in web applications. Why? Because how effective we developed a website is one side, and how we are reaching our targeting customers is another side. So we need to reach our targeting customers with the help of search engine optimization. So with the help of the meta tag, the things are implemented with the help of the meta tag. So second one is browser compatibility. If you take any browser, the view is same, there is no difference. Let us take the different web browsers are Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox, UC Browser, Opera, etc. If you run this HTML file, including CSS, will run on all same view. There is no change at all. Okay. The next one is appearance. Okay. Without CSS, the web page is like similarly black and white movie. If we are using CSS with HTML with CSS, it gives more look and feel. Okay. Next one is maintainability. Maintenance is very less. Why? Because we are writing one CSS file for common, and we can create multiple HTML pages. Okay. We call this CSS file in multiple HTML pages, it gives same. If you change any modifications are required, we change here, automatically it reflects the remaining pages. So next we need bandwidth saving. So each and every HTML page we are writing styles is very much difficult in handling it. But with only one CSS file to call multiple times, automatically the accessing speed increases, the less bandwidth is required. So file size, so this is also same, almost all equivalent to the meaning. And the tableless layouts means already we explained with the help of the tables how we are designing web pages. Without using web tables also we can develop web pages that are called divs, also called as divisions. Okay, now we are entering into the CSS selectors. CSS selectors allow you to select and manipulate HTML elements. Okay, allows you to select and manipulate HTML elements. The element selector selects elements based on the element name. Like, let us take P is one selector, and we are giving more to the P element, automatically it reflects. Similarly, H1 to H6. If you take any tag, okay, it reflects. Okay. Now, how it is? We are defining P tag, okay, paragraph tag, paragraph selector, and we give text align is center and color is red, So whenever I am using p tag, automatically the text will be aligned center and the color will be changed to red. That is the minimum fundamental rule, minimum changes affected in the web page. Okay, that is what exactly. In the second one, id selector. The id selector uses the id attribute of an HTML element to select a specific element. An id should be unique within a page, so the id selector is used if you want to select a single or unique element. Okay, so let us go. So the id selector is used with the help of hash, the name of the selector. So the name of selector and curly bracket begin. In between, what are the attributes we defined that will be reflected whenever we are using the id is the particular id name. Okay, here slash para 1 text align center, color is red. Here the first p paragraph where I am using id is equal to para 1 and second one I am not using it, so only this p tag will be reflected, this p tag will not be reflected. Okay, that is the way we are using ids. So the next one is the class selector. The class selector selects elements with a specific class attribute. Okay, so class attributes are represented with dot. Okay, so here we are using dot and center align apply. Wherever you are using class is equal to that class name, obviously it reflects it. Is and IDs and selectors are not at all implemented for only one tag. It can be used for multiple tags. Okay, that is what exactly here it indicates. And coming to the grouping selector, means H1 is same center and red, H2 center and red, paragraph center and red. So we write in multiple ways. Instead of writing it, we can write in a single way with comma, separated by comma. H1 comma H2 comma P, we apply this. Automatically the reflections apply to all the things. So this is what exactly. So once I recap the story, so directly we are using tag is a selector. Okay, what are the attributes we are attribute values we are assigning, automatically that changes will be reflected. That is the first point. And slash use for id selector. Okay, and dot is used for class selector. And so comma separating multiple tags with comma separates grouping selector. So this is what exactly in the entire CSS we are using. Any combinations means normal selector or id selector or class selector or grouping selectors are used in giving more look and feel of our HTML tag. Thank you. And in the next video, practically we need to show selector tags, id selector and class selector, and also grouping selector with practical experience. Thank you.